at Jim's house one Friday night. You were with Tim, but then I was with Mike. We went out for drinks and we had a great time. You gave me your number and I gave you mine. You told me to call and we do it again. But I bet you say that to all of the men, 'cause it seems that you are never at home. You never answer your telephone. I'm so tired of talking to your answering machine. Are you really away or are you just being mean? Maybe you don't really like me at all. Maybe you're really just screening my phone call.
Hello, this is Robert. I'm sorry that I'm not here to answer the phone, but please leave a message at the sound of the tone.
I dial your number at least twice a day. A glutton for punishment, what can I say? When I hear it ring, I'm on needles and pins, till I hear a click and the message begins. I know it by heart and I wait for the tone. Feeling rejected, feeling alone, 'cause 30 seconds isn't long enough to tell you everything I feel. Why did you give me your number if you didn't want to talk to me for real?
Hello, Robert, this is David. Remember we met the other night? Well, I'm not really sure why I called. I guess I just called to say hello, so hello. My number is 665-8832.
Why do you bother having it on? When I leave a message, you never respond. Well, I should be hurt, but I'm worried instead. Perhaps you've been kidnapped, or maybe you're dead. All kinds of nightmares are going through my brain. I call the police, but I don't know your last name. Avoiding phone calls is a science, but conversation is an art. Why did you give me your number if you only meant to break my heart?
Hello, Robert, this is David again. Probably didn't get my earlier message, so I just thought I'd call back. And I was just wondering what you're doing tomorrow night. I thought maybe if you weren't doing anything else, maybe we could...
30 seconds isn't long enough to tell you everything I feel. Why did you give me your number if you didn't wanna